growing on a tree, white and pink and lazy as can be. But I'd be king just in the spring, so now I think it over. Gee, I'm glad I'm no one else but me. If you sit around and find the world is gloomy, and it isn't just your cup of tea, it's easy to imagine that it's rosy. Imagining's a lot of fun, but when there are battles to be won, be what you are, it's best by far, and soon you'll be in clover. Gee, I'm glad I'm no one else but me.
Hey everyone, welcome to my channel, The Dancing Baker Canada. If you haven't been here before, I'm Stephen, and if you have, you're probably wondering, where in the hell have you been? Okay, fair enough. So, once the borders started opening up this past summer, Lunenburg became very, very busy. So, I was working full-time, but not only that, I also took on the position of town crier, so I had some added responsibility. And I managed to book some work on a great new TV series titled Moonshine on CBC. So if you haven't watched it yet, make sure to check out Moonshine on the CBC. So for my first video back, I thought I wanted to make something easy but delicious. So today we're going to make a luscious chocolate tart. Now, not only is this chocolate tart delicious, it's also gluten-free and get this, dairy-free. So before we get started, hit that subscribe button. I'm just gonna dust off my apron and we're good to go. Okay, not bad, eh? It still fits. We're going to start with our crust. So we're going to go to our dry ingredients. Here, I take 2 cups of almond flour. Just dump it in, get rid of that. I have 1/4 cup of cocoa. And 1/2 teaspoon of salt. That's sea salt, by the way, nice and fine. And I'm just going to give that a little mix around in here. Good, good, good. Now we have our binders. In here is 1/4 cup of coconut oil, which I've melted down. So I'm just going to pour that in. And to give it its sweetness, 3 tablespoons of maple syrup. I'm using pure maple syrup. I'm sure you could use whatever you like, but I like the good stuff. So I'm just going to get all of that in there and I'm going to give it a mix around. And literally that is your crust. Now, obviously you want to make sure that it's mixed in thoroughly. There we go. And I'm just going to give you a little look at what that should look like there. Okay, good. Okay. That looks about right. So next up, I'm going to grab my tart pan. Here, check this out. Very nice. That's a 9-inch tart pan, and I love this. Watch this. That comes out. That is so cool. And for this particular tart pan, I don't even have to grease it. So I am just going to dump all my ingredients in there. And I'm going to start with my spoon to spread it out, but then I'm just gonna get right in there with my fingers. Now, what you wanna do is you wanna make sure that you press it all out all the way to the tops of the edges to get that beautiful, beautiful shape there. So I'm just going to start pressing down with my hands, which yes, I've washed. There we go, just like there. Now, as I said, take it right out to the edges and up, and that way you're going to get that lovely, lovely, beautiful shape. Okay, I'm just gonna give you a quick look here. There we go, that is fabulous. I am just going to pop this into my oven, which I preheated to 350. So here we go. Okay, so I just popped that in the oven at 350. It's gonna bake for about 12 minutes. So while that's baking, I thought I'd just...
Spice!
What can I say? The 80s were my jam. Let's go over to the stove. Welcome to my stove. I'm going to take my saucepan, turn on the element to about medium high. Then I'm going to take a cup and a half of coconut milk and just dump it in. Now, you want to keep stirring this because you don't want it to burn, obviously. And you want it to heat to the point where it's going to start to bubble up on the outside edge of the saucepan. Okay, that looks about good. Now I'd show you, but I know I'd end up dumping it all on the floor. So I'm just gonna meet you back at the counter. Okay, so here we go. We're back at the counter. In here, I have 2 cups of dark chocolate chunks, which I've already chopped up to make smaller. And I'm just going to take my very warm coconut milk and pour it right in the center of that. Now, what you want to do is you want to cover it with a plate for about 30 seconds or so. I'll just get rid of this. Okay, that should be about good. I'll just remove the plate, get rid of that. And I'm going to start stirring this in the center. And to this, I'm going to add a teaspoon of vanilla. And that, again, is the real stuff, the real deal. Just get rid of that. And now, this is really gonna make the flavor come alive. 1/4 teaspoon of sea salt. Oh, there we go. Here, let's just get all of that in there. Good stuff. And you just keep stirring around until it makes kind of like a luscious kind of mousse type flavor, or mousse type looking thing here. Good, this really is not dissimilar from a chocolate ganache. And you know, when you eat this, you feel like you're eating a big, luscious chunk of chocolate ganache. It's really quite delicious. Okay, here we go. I'm just gonna show you this. There we are. Now, I love these. If you could get yourself one of these are perfect. I'm going to take my tart shell, which I've cooled and is baked up beautifully. Here, I'm just going to tilt it ever so carefully. And all I do is I take this luscious chocolate mixture and I just pour it in. It's really that easy. And you want to get, obviously, as much of it as you can. There, that should be good. Now, what I love about this recipe is, like, much like many of my friends, it is so versatile. You can add a little bit of cinnamon and cayenne to give it a Mexican flavor, or perhaps a little brandy or Grand Marnier, or what have you. It's really great. Now, for the top, again, you could do whatever you like. I thought that I might dust this with a little bit of toasted coconut, but instead, I just toasted up a few almond slivers, and I'm just going to sprinkle them on the top throughout. Now, you see how quick and easy this dessert was? You're going to want to chill this in the fridge for about 2 hours to let it set. And then I'll come back at the end to show you the finished product. Okay, just dump those in there. Boom, I'll see you in a bit. Hey everyone, so it's been a couple of hours and the tart should be sufficiently chilled. Now you're probably thinking, hey, you're wearing glasses. You haven't worn them for the whole video. That's right, because I'm thinking of wearing glasses from now on in my videos. So what do you think? Off, on, off, on. It doesn't really matter. I'm gonna take them off for now just for continuity, and for sure, I'm not going to be dancing with them. So this next part, I'm just gonna take the tart out of the pan. So I have my cake stand. Now I'm going to flip it over. I'm not gonna lie, when I first did this, it made me really, really nervous. So I'm just gonna show you the tart in its pan. It's been chilling for a couple of hours. Isn't that beautiful? So I take it, now you remember it has that bottom. I place it on the cake stand and I very gently loosen the sides and it just falls off like that. Isn't that amazing? Now, obviously I can't keep it there like that. So I'm just gonna very carefully transfer it to another plate. I'll just move this over just ever so slightly. Pick it up. Voila, look at that. A gorgeous, rich, dark chocolate tart with sea salt, gluten-free, and dairy-free. And I'm telling you, this dessert is best served, like many things in life, with a little bit of whipped cream. Now, usually this is the part where I might take a bite and go, yum! But I'm not gonna do that today because I'm taking this to a friend. But why don't you give this a try? And if you give it a try, leave me a comment in the comments below. But I'm telling you, with this dessert, you can't go wrong. Hey everyone, thanks for checking out my channel. Now, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and maybe share with your friends. You can also follow me on Instagram at The Dancing Baker Canada. So until next time, whenever the hell that is, I'm just gonna leave you here with this. Whack, boom, ha! See you next time!